start at the point of sacrifices. Are you hearing me? Apostle Paul writes to the Corinthians, he tells them, the message of the cross, it is foolishness for those who are perishing. But it is the power to us who are saved. Now, what is the message of the cross? What are we learning in the cross except the sacrifice? The cross is there to crucify someone. Am I talking? Now, Jesus came and became a sacrifice and was crucified to the cross. Now, Apostle Paul said, the message about sacrifice, it is foolishness to people who are lost. But to us of faith, it is the secret of what? Power. It is the secret of what? Power. Now, we are seeing again Jesus happening to tell the disciples, if anyone wants to come after me, other way, if anyone wants to become a Christian, he must pick up what? His cross and follow me. Meaning, if anyone wants to be a Christian, he must never forget the sacrifice. He must pick up that sacrificial life and do what? Follow me. Now, we call ourselves Christians. When we say Christian, what does it mean? It means Christ life. Who was Christ? Christ was the Lamb. Christ was the sacrifice. Then when you say you are Christ-like, meaning you are also a sacrifice. Apostle Paul writes to the Romans, he said, I urge you to sacrifice your body as the living sacrifice. Yes, we have so many teachings today, which they are telling you, you must not fast. Jesus fasted for you. Jesus did for you. Whatsoever it is. They know what they are handing to the people. Let me tell you how the spirit of occult is working today. Satan is doing his things. You know, they are looking and they are targeting for church. They are targeting for pastors. The same way Satan went to Jesus, he told him, if you bow before me, I will give you all these kingdoms. I will make you fair. All these kingdoms to be yours. You will be famous. Jesus said, I will not, for it is written. The same things the devil is continuing with it today. You see, when these people are coming to see us, what are they telling you? They are saying, we will make you fair. We can pay TV for you 2 years full. Every car that comes is released, you can have it. They will not tell us to change anything in the church, but their condition, their message, their topic, which they tell you, you must never preach on this topic. Are you getting what I'm saying? You will see, we'll still come in the church, we'll still see, but the contract you sign with them, their topic of message, you agree with them, you will never preach it again. Things like the coming of Jesus, they tell you, put it out. Everything of prosperity, preach. Your life can be saved, preach. Talking of deliverance, preach. But the message like the coming of Christ, you never preach it again. Things of people sacrificing themselves to God, never preach it again. The sanctification, holiness, never preach it again. Are you here? I'm talking, I'm not a guest speaker here. I'm a father here. All the truth must be known. That's why you can walk in a certain church, you will not know that they are already compromised, because the same song they sing, it's the same song we sing, but the problem is not happening within the church, the problem is in the pulpit. The message has changed. And many people are sitting at the church like that. And many people are even enjoying the message like fasting is not important. You don't need to fast. Jesus fasted. They enjoy. They same things that were supposed to empower you, to make you strong. In another language, you say, so no, no. Satan knows. For a person who don't understand the sense of sacrifice, for someone who does not spend time before God without food and water, that particular person can never beat the desire of the flesh. No matter how much you will wish to leave fornication, you will find doing it. No matter how much you will wish to leave drunkenness, you will find yourself doing it. Why? Because your flesh have never been sacrificed to God. Are you getting what I'm saying? Now, Jesus said, he who come after me must pick up what? His cross. The cross for what? What did the cross of Jesus did to Jesus? It killed Jesus. Now, this body of yours must be crucified. The body must be what? Crucified. The first sacrifice that God is expecting to us, as Apostle Paul said, offer your body as the living sacrifice. The first sacrifice that the Lord is expecting, it is our body, our life, to be sacrificed, to be given to Him. Unfortunately, today, the sacrifice that we preach more is the money. Is it?
Yes, it's true.
We like to talk of the money. Money will come a later. What God is pleased with, it is what? Your body. Listen to what Jesus is saying. He said, bear offerings and sacrifices, you will not please. This is a great revelation. God has never enjoyed. Did you ever read of the God being taken to the temple, the sacrifices to God? God has never enjoyed those sacrifices. Which sacrifice that pleases God? Jesus said, you have made me the body. I have come to do your will. Here, Jesus, God made Jesus to become the body, and that body was supposed to be sacrificed to Him. That's the only offering that they have ever pleased God. You can give God, when who said God like your money offerings? Every time you give money, you're giving money for you to get what? Money. It means you are doing it to bless you. And sometimes God takes it, sometimes He rejects it. What is more important to God is your life. Is what? Now, during this prayer meeting, this is where we started. Your body needs to be crucified. The body needs to die. Die in yourself. You dying in yourself, what does it mean? It means the rulership of the body will never be a problem to you. Drunkenness will no more be a challenge while you are dead. I am dead in pride. I cannot be proud. I am dead in flesh. Then I cannot walk in fornication. I cannot feed for liquor. Because my flesh has been doing what? Is dead and been crucified.
Hallelujah.
That's what the Lord said. If you want to come after me, take your cross. Why? Your cross must kill the desire of your flesh. For the Bible says, the desire of your flesh, it is a sinful nature. The desire of the flesh, it is what? Sinful nature. The desire of the Spirit, it is life and peace. Then what must we do? When we are coming in the fasting, we have been taught wrong and we need to correct this impression. You are not fasting to get a car. The fasting does not qualify you to get a car. Being a child of God qualifies you to get for what you are looking for. Yeah. Are you getting what I'm saying? Now, why are we fasting? We are fasting that our flesh must reduce. Our spirit must grow. Yes. Am I talking? Because until you are spiritual grown, then you can never receive from God. Because even that Range Rover you are expecting, when God gives it to you, He will firstly give it to you spiritual, not natural. When you receive it here spiritual, then you will see it coming to pass. The people like the Mama person, they have received their car key here in the church. When they go out there, it materializes. Firstly, everything of God is firstly what? Spiritual. Now, spiritual things is only for the spiritual people. That's why we come in the same church, being preached by the same pastor, but we are not seeing the same result. What is the problem? It depends on our spirituality. They are those who are growing spiritual, and they are those who are dead spiritual. Are you getting what I'm saying? Now, every time you are fasting, meaning you are reducing the flesh nature, you call it booster. You see, some other people, when they want more energy in them, what do they do? They take an energy what? Booster. Your spirit man is inactive. Why? Because you are so weak spiritually. Now, when you begin to fast, what you are doing? You are taking a spiritual booster. Yeah. Am I talking?
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Someone said power.
Power.
You see, I met a certain sister who came from the Bethlehem church. She came to see me at the office. I like what she said. And I like the church where she goes. And I've been told her, do you know that I belong to that church? Me, I'm a part of that church. She told me, yes, my sister told me. She told me like that, you're also part of that church. I said, I love that church. I have a sister. Why are you here? The sister told me something I enjoy to hear. Sister told me, say, the issues I'm going through, I know it can find the answer in this church. That's why I have come. Say, wow. Say, okay. It's good that you have come. Let's begin now to attend to it. Now, you are the child of this house. You don't need to be ignorant in anything concerning the power of God. Am I talking?
Amen.
Just imagine you meet such person and you are from this house. You hear the pastor week in, week out. You are struggling. But someone who does not belong here is believing if he step here, things will change. This sister here was not coming here. I don't know where she was going. Maybe Victoria, but too far. She met with someone who told her, said, wow, go there in 26. I was there. My problem has been done there. Go there. You are going too far. Now, can you imagine people who are not part of this church? They know something of this church, which you who are here, you are not benefiting from. Are you normal? Am I talking? Now, how will you become the beneficiary? How will you partake? Brother, sister, there is no any other mechanism except by the teaching I'm teaching you now. Are you hearing me? Because we have been taught wrong. But every time you want a car, every time you want married, fast. No. They're supposed to tell us, fasting will make you strong spiritually. And being spiritual strong, you can receive easily from God. But they were not supposed to tell you, you give God fasting and God give you money. No. Am I talking? Because God is spiritual. And what He gives is spiritual. For you to receive it, you must be spiritual. Then where is fasting coming in? Fasting is helping us in our spirit to grow. Look at you. Look at you as you are. Look at you. You will see some of you, your body is already reflecting what? Weakness. You're already tired. You're going to become what? Weak. And one mistake you are doing. You know, when your body is weak, it's a very good time to pray. Yeah. But unfortunately, you don't utilize that momentum. You want to pray when your body is what? Strong. No. Your body must be silent. Your spirit must do what? Pray. Now, every time your body is weak, meaning your spirit is willing now. Jesus said, the flesh is weak, but the spirit is willing. Every time your body is tired, pushing prayer is the right moment. Your prayer will be effective. First book of Corinthians. Chapter number 9. Let's start it from verse 24. First book of Corinthians, chapter number 9. Let's start it from verse 24.
And everyone who competes for the prize is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a perishable crown, but we for a perishable crown. Therefore, I run thus, not with uncertainty. Thus I fight, not as one who beats the air, but I discipline my body and bring it into subjection.
I want you to read that one after him.
But I discipline my body, and bring it unto subjection, lest when I have preached to others, I myself should become disqualified.
Who is that New Living Translation? Yeah, read that 27, New Living Translation.
I discipline my body like an athlete, training it to do what it should. Otherwise, I fear that after preaching to others, I myself might be.
God bless you. I discipline my body like an athlete. You see now, discipline of your body becoming obvious. Let me spend some few minutes to talk to you. I discipline my body like an athlete. Athletes who are doing big competition, like Bo Castasola, it's a man, those ones. When you have a friend in that profession, you will learn exactly what discipline they go to. You see, like you drink cold drink, anytime you want cold drink, oh, I feel like I got they don't go to those things. And those guys will tell you, a day I have to drink 5 liters of water. Do you even know the number of water you drink a day? And one will tell you, I run 21 kilometers every day. When you see them getting crowd, You enjoy, you celebrate them, but you don't know what they go through for them to get that result. They have teach their body very well. Now, Apostle Paul is saying, us also, we are running a race. Run in such a way that you may get the prize, which is not a perishable. He said, I discipline myself like the athlete does. You see, the athlete will not tell you, he will not tell you, oh no, I'm weak, I don't want to run today. He knows the less he runs, the chance of him losing comes. Amen? But what happened to us? How many times do we pray? And do you know why we don't pray? We don't pray because of our body. Through of us.
That's true.
You have the mind to pray, but you wake up and the body tells you, no, I'm still sleeping, I still feel. What do you do? Now, between you and your body, which one is subdued to the other? You are doing opposite of what you were supposed to do. Now, you need to begin to learn how to discipline what? Your body. Hear the apostle what he said. I do that. Another version says, I punish my body. Lest after preaching to others to go to heaven, myself I will come to miss heaven. He was right. What does it mean? Preaching knowledge, I can preach knowledge. But living according to that knowledge, my body must be disciplined for that. Now the reason why you have preachers, after he finished to preach, go in his house, big bottle of wine. He's drinking it like no one's business.
Yeah.
I was talking to someone, I said, why are you drinking? Why are you so alcoholic? You drink wine like? He told me, you know, where I, this wine I did not know it before. I know it from, he named the name of the person. The person he was naming is a pastor. He said, yeah, from the first time I know this wine, I know it from him. And in this generation, others are coming in the pulpit drunk. The other one walking in the pulpit on the 31st, tell the choir, I said, put that song of Michael Jackson. Put that song of Michael Jackson there. Now, why can things get to that point? Is when they neglect certain elements. Mm. Jesus tells us, when you come after me, never forget about your cross. Carry your cross. Sacrifice is the way to go. Apostle Paul, if you want to talk about men of God who have sacrificed themselves, you have to mention this man, Apostle. This guy, with all human senses, this guy refused to marry. And they never catch him with someone's wife. Haha! That one I'm refusing food, which one is strong? Or you don't eat in the morning, you eat late in the evening. And who in our midst will refuse never to get married? Not just because the desire of the flesh is too much to you. No, you're dreaming to have family, right? You want to have your son, you have your grandson, your daughter. And this guy, he said, for the kingdom of God, things which were looking important to me, I look at it as rubbish. For the excellent knowledge of Christ. Now you will come and tell me sacrifice is nothing. Oh Jesus. Where are we taking the church of God? Those nonsense, we don't preach it here. Sacrifices is a message. The message of the cross. us, it what? Power. You see the crosses. The message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishable. You see where I come from? If you say you are a pastor and you have a stomach like mine, they say you are not spiritual. I'm telling you. And this year in our church, Pastor David, none of us must have a stomach. Tell those who are not here. We refuse stomach. Pastor Rito, do you open this part? There is this man, Papa Adeboye, in Nigeria. The church of that Papa in one Holy Ghost Friday, it gathered 4 million of people. Reading Christian Church of God, follow it on TV. When they have the Friday Holy Ghost, ushers, they use car in their structure. They are ushers, they move with, you see those cars that is in the airport? They use those cars because you can't walk. And as I follow the life of that man very close, that man said, I feel pity for the one who will take this church after I'm gone. He said, to lead this church presently, my days of eating is less than my days of fasting in a year. A certain pastor visited, he found that Papa in the fasting. That Papa tell him, I'm in my 38 days of fasting. I was just thanking God for the crusade that he helped me that time. That young preacher said, what? 38 days of what? Of thanking God. He said, we the young preacher, 38 days is power. We'll not be thanking God. We are asking for power. I cannot just fast many days like all this fasting. You are just saying what? Thanks to God. Yep. The people who have discovered the secret of sacrifice, they are moving with God in the high places.
Yeah.
Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Witchcraft will not torment you. You will not be tormented by small things. You they beat you every night. If last night it was the head, this next day is the back. if they don't do this to you, no. Christianity goes with power. The Bible said to those who have received him, to those who believe in him, he gives them what? Power to become children of God. You can't be a powerless child of God. It doesn't make sense. Are you getting what I'm saying? It doesn't make sense. Now, to maintain the power of God in you, your body must be what? Crucified. Your body must be what? Disciplined. Your body must be disciplined. Thank God for you. Because you are going home. Others are going to take different kind of soup. Gravy and whatever you call it, chakalaka. Some others will eat like they are in parties. You will start with breakfast. After you get home, you start with breakfast. You go to the lunch. And you join them to supper. Within 3 hours, you take all the mucus. Beloved, my time is gone, we have to pray. If you follow the things I'm teaching you, you will never stand here one day you are looking for deliverance. You will know what we call auto-deliverance. What we call auto-deliverance. Self-deliverance. Am I talking? Because the devil will not stand your ground. Because flesh will be dead in you. Spirit shall rise in you. And know every satanic projection, it's against your flesh. It's against what? Your flesh. Any satanic projection is against your flesh, your body. Okay, let me tell you something. That's the only things God ever loves Satan. For you to understand, read the book of Job. When Job went to see God, when Job wanted to, Satan wanted to touch Job. Why did God tell Satan to touch? He said, touch his body, his material, but don't touch his spirit. Now, every time we are flesh, Satan have much to do with us. But when they come in you, they don't farm the flesh in you. There's nothing. Jehovah. Another preaching is coming by itself. You know, when they wanted to build the ark of Noah, the Lord telling the tree in which he have to use. Joker, I don't know how to call it in English. Now, in this tree, they have to drain out water. For you to take a wood from the tree have to go through a process. Water have to be dried out. And when you take that wood, then you can be able to do the ark of Noah. When they wanted to do the ark of covenant, God gave the specific tree which supposed to be taken. That tree have to go through the process. They have to drain out all the water. The Lord God is looking for people during this program who will stand. Tell the Holy Ghost, drain out of me all the feeling of the world. Drain out of me all the lust of the flesh. Drain out of me all the desire of the world. Drain out of me. Make me to become like that. I'm looking for those names in English, man. What are the names of those three in English? We have Akasha tree. Is Akasha English? Akasha is English? Tell God, make me like this wood of Akasha. Pull out of me all the water. Until that process were taken, it was not able to make the ark of covenant. Until the world is drained out of you, you are not ready to get in. Are you still here? This is the year of the Holy Ghost. This is the year of the Holy Ghost. Let the desire of the Spirit grow much in you. Let the one of the flesh begin to reduce. How does the one of the world and the flesh reduce? It is by killing your sinful nature. Are you getting what I'm saying? Yes, this, it only comes by spiritual discipline. Review your body. Never again allow your body to command you. When you want to pray, the body says, see, I say, are you aware where your body is going? Your body is going not to heaven. It's going back to. Now, when you keep subdued to it, it will take you there. But your body must be disciplined to follow you. When you set that alarm, you set that things to pray, you must pray. No matter how many sleeping it is there, you must pray. Samuel.